I'm going to share with you a way that you can create some texture and introduce some design on your work using a resist technique called water etch. What you need to do water etch is you need some sort of resist. I'm going to use this Mod Podge. You could also use an acrylic medium. Both of these are pretty easy water cleanup, just soap and water, and they are low on fumes, so they're easy to work with. You could also use shellac. That does require alcohol cleanup, and it can be somewhat smelly, so you want to make sure that you have some ventilation in your workspace if you choose to use that. I've also used wax resist to do this, and it doesn't hold up super well, but it does hold up for just a little bit. Okay, the other thing that you're going to need is you're going to need an item that is leather hard or possibly bone dry. One of the cool things about this technique is that if you've forgotten about a piece in the studio and you meant to carve it or put some slip on, and now your piece is bone dry and you think it's too late to do anything with it, it's not. You can do this resist technique and still incorporate some texture into your work without carving and creating clay dust. The other thing that you're going to need is some paint brushes. So with this technique, you do have to paint the resist on, so your only limitation is your ability to control your paintbrush. So the way we're going to do it is we're going to take a little bit of this Mod Podge. As you can see, it looks like white glue, but it dries clear. And I'm going to take my my leather hard cup here, and I'm just going to start to paint on it. You can paint any design that you like. You can paint imagery, like I said. The only thing you're limited by is your ability to control a paintbrush. So, I mean, you can get nice crisp lines. If you end up using a paintbrush sometimes and things look blobby, that's exactly what you're gonna get. It doesn't change. So just know that maybe if controlling a paintbrush, or you don't like the way the paintbrush makes your paint look, you know, maybe this isn't the technique for you. So you're just going to keep painting on here until you've got your design on there and your work is, or your Mod Podge rather, is dry to the touch. So I'm going to set that down for a while so that that can dry. Put some water in my paintbrush to clean that out. And when your work becomes, when the shellac on there becomes dry, you can go back then. You're going to need a sponge and some water. And I've already done part of this bone dry tile, and you're just going to start wiping away. Now you can see it's hard sort of to see, like I started sponging here and you can see where the texture pops, but every once in a while you catch a little shine from the shellac. It was hard to see, so one thing that I did was I just took some cheapo paints, and my tile was bone dry. So I just painted some watercolor on there, and then when I painted with the Mod Podge, I could see a little bit easier where I was painting. So you might want to choose to do that. The watercolor will burn away in most cases, but if you wanted to play around and use an underglaze or some colored slip or engobe on your leather hard piece, and then Mod Podge on top of it, you definitely can do that. But I also think that this is going to help you to be able to see my resist pattern a little easier. So you're going to take a sponge and you're going to start to just wipe your piece. Now, if your piece is super thin, you're going to need to be careful because you can crack pieces from adding water to them. But if you've got something, this tile's maybe a quarter of an inch thick, and it's just, honestly, it's just leftover, so it's not a big deal to me. I just like to keep things like this around so I can practice techniques like this. But you can see I'm just sort of scrubbing back and forth. I'm rinsing my sponge occasionally. And what's starting to happen is everywhere where there is the resist, it stays high. And then next to it, that clay becomes lower. I'm actually removing some clay away from the surface. And so I'm getting this result of this light texture on there. Now, You know, make sure that you don't go too deep. Like I said, if you have something thin, you want to sort of stop when it's light. But you can actually keep scrubbing and scrubbing pretty far. And as long as your shellac or your Mod Podge holds up, you can get this to be a pretty pronounced texture. Now, one of the things that I love doing with this after this is bisque fired and it comes time to glaze it, I'd like to use a glaze on it, something that is translucent, like a Celadon glaze or something like a Chino glaze, or glazes that break over edges and show a lot of texture. So that's one way that you can enrich more of your work and put some texture on there, even if your piece is already bone dry.